how to use the forces to keep the contact, or how to use the PD's controller to produce the motion. But of course, this directly transfers, like directly observed skill, is not optimal for each agent. So a good example is if you want to play tennis, you can get a good idea of how to play good tennis by watching, let's say, Roger Federer, but you'll never become Roger Federer if you just watch him. So you have to try yourself to physically optimize for your own specifics. So, of course, this is, I'll tell you the whole procedure. So first, the expert robot is produced by observing the human and working with the human. And then when the when we have one expert robot, the novice robot can learn from the expert robot through the task performance with the expert robot. So you have this multi-stage process. Now it's the second stage. You can see it's much better than it was at the beginning. Much less perturbation. And then in the final stage, when the novice robot learns both the motion and the impedance behavior, they can perform this task